Welcome to Temperature Taking for Dummies. People often make small talk about the weather, and much of this small talk centers around how hot or cold it is outside. If you stick around for a few minutes, I'll let you in on some secrets about how and where the official temperature is taken. You may also find this helpful if you want to set up your own backyard weather station. The two types of weather stations shown here are used by the National Weather Service. The station on the upper right is the Automated Surface Observing System, or ASOS, and it is located at more than 900 airports across the country. These ASOS sites are typically referenced by the media as the official temperature record for a city. These stations began reporting in the 1990s, but many of these locations had manually recorded weather observations nearby, dating back too many decades. The cooperative weather station on the lower left, also known as a co-op station, is part of an extensive network of more than 11,000 volunteers who take observations on farms, in urban and suburban areas, national parks, seashores, and mountaintops. Co-op stations may also be used as the official temperature record. Both of these types of weather stations help define the climate of the United States. Here are the temperature sensor units found at typical co-op and ASOS sites. Although they look different, they are actually similar. These temperature sensors do not use liquid mercury or alcohol. Instead, they are electronic and use the principle that electrical resistance varies with temperature. Both of these units are painted white to reflect sunlight, and the temperature sensors are inside the housing unit to keep them in the shade. The ASOS temperature unit uses a fan to keep airflow over the sensor at all times, while the co-op sensor relies on the wind for airflow. Both of these sites have their temperature sensor near the optimum height of 5 feet above the ground. The height of a temperature sensor or thermometer should be between 4 and 6 feet. Some co-op observing sites still use a cotton region shelter that contains mercury or alcohol thermometers. The liquid inside the thermometer expands as the temperature rises and contracts when it cools. These shelters are designed to keep the thermometer in the shade, allow for good airflow, and are painted white to reflect sunlight. You want to place your thermometer in a representative area with good air circulation that is not influenced by artificial conditions. Bank thermometers are in bad locations that are above pavement, in direct sunlight, and sometimes near the side of a building. Another bad location is on a sporting event field. The thermometer is often too close to the ground and in direct sunlight. If you only want to know the temperature on your deck, then simply place your thermometer there in the shade. However, if you want to collect a regionally representative temperature, then you need to locate your thermometer about 5 feet high, shaded, and in an open air exposure away from nearby buildings, trees, and roads. Most backyards are too small to be perfect, but do the best you can.